This is the Low Key Podcast. I do not own the rights to the music that's being played in future podcasts or past podcasts. Once again, this is the Low Key Podcast, episode 23, therapy session.
Santana. I like that, man. Got to go. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. That's hot.
Who am I?
Yeah, who are you?
Who am I?
Santana.
Man.
Y'all think niggas don't cry, man?
We do.
Yeah, man. I gotta get my thoughts together, man. I be thinking a lot, man.
Light up a blunt.
Be crying sometimes too. But it's like,
yo. What's going on? What's going on? This is the Low Key Podcast, episode 23, therapy session. Tonight I'm gonna get into mostly mental health awareness, and even talking about some of my mental health. So I can basically try to relate to anybody that's got situations going on as far as mental health go, or even situations that's similar to mine. So I can't say that I'm going to dive real deep into my situation, but I'm going to give some perspective of things that I have going on just so I can relate to whoever else got going on. And like I said, you can leave comments or anything, and you can definitely link in into the platform as far as Spotify, iHeartMedia, Apple Music. I'm on all of those, and also Sprinker. But I want to basically talk about things people are going through as far as mental health, especially in these times in 2020 when we have a lot of people on lockdown and have to stay in the house because a lot of people's livelihood are them going outside, you know what I'm saying, as far as being around other people or even just being out. Me being who I am, I'm able to deal with certain situations like this lockdown. Like, I'm good because I'm not a people person like that anyway. Not to say I don't like being around people, but I'm just not the person that's popping up everywhere, being around everybody or trying to see what's up or whatnot. But not to say I don't want to be around nobody. It's just how I deal with situations and how I want to deal with as far as talking to a bunch of people or whatnot. I'm not sure if you want to call it anxiety or whatnot, but I guess looking on the outside, I guess I can see how people look at it is maybe some people would think you being funny or you got an attitude or this and that and the third, you know what I'm saying, as far as how you act or how you usually act around people. Because you can be happy-go-lucky, telling people, yo, hit me up, doing this and the third, and then next minute, people like, damn, why you ain't hit me up? Or why I ain't heard from you? What's in this and the third? And they think you acting funny or whatnot, not knowing that you having to take time to yourself to get your own things together, because you're not realizing that if you do reach out or you do say something to this person, you might lash out because you got stuff going on and they not understanding, like, why you acting this way? But they not realizing that you taking time to yourself because you don't want to lash out or you don't want to be this type of way because you got stuff going on and something could just hit you out the gate to make you just want to go off about certain things because dealing with certain things or you got so much going on in your mind. And people don't understand it. And I'm not talking about myself, for instance. I'm just saying on the outside looking in and seeing other people, and me might be me taking something the wrong way and saying, like, yo, what's up with you? Like, you were just cool the other day. Like, what's wrong now? And it's like, you ain't understanding. Like, I got something going on. And just because I'm not reaching back to you or saying anything don't mean I got an issue with you. It just means I got something going on right now, and I got to take some time to myself. And that's me saying, okay, maybe this person got something going on. Maybe I got something going on. And I hope I ain't confusing nobody or sounding like I'm not clear with what I'm saying. But I'm basically saying is, if you have a friend, brother, sister, mother, I don't know, care, or I'm not saying I don't care, but I'm saying I don't know who it is or whatever, but if you got somebody you care about, somebody you love, etc., and you always talk to that person and you decide, I'm going to hit this person up today, I want to see what they're doing, I want to go hang out or this and the third, and they say, nah, not today, or they just don't hit you back, you might take it a certain way. You might be like, damn, I guess they trying to be funny or they don't want to talk to me no more. Cool, but it might not be that. that person might be just going through something. You might hit them up and they might bust out in tears or something for no reason, just because they want to hang out or they want to do something, but they mentally just can't do it right now because they got something going on or so much going on. You never know, because people feel like they can't express themselves truthfully, especially when you got out of the three people, two that really don't care and they ain't trying to hear nothing anyway. But you got that one person that do care, but you don't know that, because as soon as you do say something or express yourself, then you got five other people hitting you up like, yo, I heard you got this going on. And you like, how did you hear this? I ain't tell you that. And that's how I go a lot of times. And people don't understand that right now I got to chill, because you never know what you're going to run up on when somebody got something going on, but you're trying to force yourself on them. And I've seen this and I've dealt with this. So, for instance, I want to give my end and say, dealing with situations as far as death, you're going to deal with depression, or you're going to deal with maybe even anxiety or certain situations where you just don't want to be around people for a long time. Because no matter what you say or no matter what you think, people deal with death different, especially when you deal with it more than once. So when you are trying to comprehend what's going on, and at the same time, make sure if you have kids that they're okay while you're dealing with your own situation, it's different. But even if you don't have kids and you're just dealing with a sister, a brother, or family members, or just all in general, you might have really, really close friends that want to know what's going on, but you just can't talk to nobody right now because you're trying to get your own self together. And you can't do that when you got everybody in your ear trying to give you suggestions, or you got everybody in your ear trying to make sure you're all right, because sometimes all that can be overwhelming and people do not realize that. And then when you lash out or tell you just step back, people feel like, oh, I was trying to help you. And they don't get it because they're not going through that. But then, to me, it all comes back around to just listening and being able to say, listen, I got something going on right now. You ain't got to say what you got going on. You ain't got to say what it is. You just say, I got something going on right now. I'll talk to you when I get a chance. Because talking and communication, or lack thereof, can cause a lot of issues. And when you finally decide to say something to somebody, that can ease a lot of tension that you might have built up or might have had. And on the other end, sometimes you can't even do that because it's just, you don't know people's intentions, man. And no matter if somebody you done known forever, somebody you love, or somebody that's a family member, you just, if you not around people 24/7 or you ain't been around people in a certain amount of time, you just don't know people's intentions. And if you done been through certain situations, whether it's dealing with family or dealing with somebody close, and then a certain situation happened again where you have to talk to somebody or you want to talk to somebody, but you don't have that trust, then what do you do? Or who do you talk to? And a lot of times people go to prayer. And I mean, don't get me wrong, when people say somebody not talking back to me as far as prayer, to me, that's just, it's you not giving yourself a chance to allow things to happen because you were ready for something to happen right then and there. And I've had that issue too, a lot of times. So when it comes to depression and having to deal with, just for instance, waking up one day and feeling like, what's wrong? Ain't nothing wrong. It's just a feeling. It's a feeling that just right there is, I can't explain it, but it's, and I'm saying this because I went through this and sometimes I still go through this, but it's just a feeling. And it's like, why am I feeling this way today? Why am I going through this right now? And you just yesterday, I was all right. I was happy as hell. I mean, I was doing everything in the third, but this morning, for some reason, everything feels like it shut down. And realize that you got to go to work like this. You got to make sure you keep in a safe face, because you don't want nobody asking you what's wrong, or you don't want nobody think you acting funny, because then it's gonna get to a point where you like, okay, I ain't acting funny, but I ain't got to explain nothing to you either. And then that's where it's going to come to aggression. Because, like, people don't understand, man. Like for me, I think most of it is just dealing with death as far as losing a child. And I've lost 2 kids. So when you go about your day and trying to keep up and making it seem like I got to care, even though I have to understand it, each morning I get up, it's going to be a morning that I get up and feel like everything is just over. It's done. Like your whole body just don't want to move. You don't want to do nothing. You feel like just shit. But for me, it's like I look at my babies and I know, nah, they can't see that. They got to see Superman. They got to see Clark Kent taking off his glasses, going in that booth and coming out with their S on and letting you know that everything good. We got this. And I got to feel like I got to install in them that you can't rely on nobody to make sure you good. You got to make sure you good. If you understand what I'm saying. But as far as just trying to deal with situations on a daily basis, because it ain't got to be just death. It could be anything people are dealing with. It could be people in debt as far as money-wise, or people trying to take care of their families as far as their kids, or it could be single-parent situations, whether it's a father or a mother just trying to take care of everything, and they don't want to go to somebody and ask them for help. That shit, for years, it builds on you, and it turns into depression, or it turns into something that weighs on you, especially your mind, because you getting up every day going to work, dealing with a situation where, damn, I got to make sure my son or my daughter, or I got to make sure my mom's straight, or I got to make sure my grandma's straight, or damn, I got to make sure such and such good, or I got to make sure I'm good. That's everything, man. And then when you're dealing with 2020 and you got people that's done lost their job, people that's going into like this month of December, Christmas time, man, and you can't do certain things, the shit, it weighs on you. And it's not about materialistic shit. It's the point of you trying to do stuff for your kids because you want to see their face, man. You don't understand. When you got kids, everything in the world is that joy, just seeing their faces when they opening their gifts and they coming up, giving you that big ass hug, holding you tight, letting you feel how much they love you because they just appreciate what you done for them. That's everything. And when you feel like you couldn't do certain things, it's like, it takes everything out of you. It's life coming out of you. So as far as just trying to deal with all of that and at the same time keep a straight face as far as your kids go, or if you don't have kids, trying to keep a straight face as far as your livelihood go. When you're trying to build a career and trying to do something outside of the box, all that shit can weigh on you as far as your mental health, man. And there's nothing wrong with saying, yo, I got to take a step back and I need my space, or talking to somebody, because I got to be honest, sometimes we do need to talk to somebody. Because sometimes just letting it out or explaining everything that's going on with you can help. But like I said, I understand that situation and not want to say nothing to nobody, because people can just take shit and flip it, or people can take shit you saying and just turn it all the way around, and then you in a situation where you don't trust nobody. And with me, it's like, you have to have some type of compromise with allowing somebody in, because you can't do this by yourself, man. You can't do it by yourself. No matter how much you want to try to do it, you can't do it by yourself. And for me, I always said my kids get me through a lot. And they do. I mean, being 16 years old and finding that you have a child, and the first thing you're thinking about is job applications. I mean, that's what it was. Because, like, you got to make sure that baby good. You got to make sure everything's straight with your child. And it's the only thing you focus on. So just imagine losing all of that. And not understanding why. Like, why? I mean, you think about every situation you done been in, everything you've done, the way you've sacrificed yourself to make sure you've done certain things to say, I'm going to be a father. No matter what comes my way, I'm going to be a father. Or I'm going to be a mother. No matter what comes my way, I'm going to be a mother. And then you get hit with shit like death or just all around. Like, why? And that's an attack on your mental health because you're not understanding certain things. And you like now every day thinking about like, why? You going to work wondering why? You getting off work wondering why? You going to bed wondering why? You getting up in the morning wondering why? So for me, it's like it came to a point of compromising with myself and trying to understand prayer, a lot of prayer, and not only prayer, but just trying to understand that you can't do this by yourself and trying to have some kind of forgiveness in your heart to yourself because a lot of times you can get into a depression by blaming yourself for situations you don't put yourself in. That turns into depression. And that turns into having the whole weight of your world on your shoulders feeling like you got to do something to prove something. Because now you feel like, what am I doing? And I'm not talking about me, for instance. I'm just saying situations I've seen or just seeing how people post stuff on Facebook or the way you see people act when you see them in person from the person you've seen from years back or the person you used to know or the person you see now. Because people fight their battles in different ways, man. And for me, instance, hearing certain situations my wife has been in, like, it's like, you a superhero, man. You done came out of all these situations. Like, what am I even complaining about? Or having an issue with when I hear everything you've been through or hearing somebody else's situation. All I'm saying is sometimes you have to talk to somebody, but on the outside world, as far as people who feel like certain people are acting a certain way, or for the people who feel like people don't want to talk to you or they being funny, you got to understand that people have things going on in their life. And people wake up one morning and they might have a whole situation going on where they just feel like ain't nothing going right. And they still trying to just go on with their day. And you might feel like they acting funny, but you ain't realizing that this person is just trying to get through the day just so they can get home and just like, but you don't even get it because you only thinking about what this person is on a daily basis in front of you, but you don't know what they like because they ain't showed you that side because you don't trust that person yet. Or you don't trust people carrying your feelings or your emotions or knowing what you got going on inside because that whole manipulation with telling somebody something you got going on because they done expressed yourself or telling somebody or telling other family members or just all around. And like I said, I'm not just talking about myself because we all have these issues. We all have these certain situations is going on, and I'm talking about everybody, whoever listening to the podcast, whether you don't have family members that you feel like don't want to hear you out, or whether you have family members that understand you have stuff going on with you, and it's not that you don't want to be around them, but you gotta need your space because you're trying to get yourself together so you can be positive. Because a lot of times you separate yourself because you feel like you have a negative energy going on with you, and you don't want to put that negative energy on nobody else. So you like, nah, I'm going to shut myself off from that. I've seen people like that, man. Like, you can tell. And even with me, I've been in situations where I'm feeling like I'm in a negative space and I don't want to bring that energy around nobody else. So I'm going to separate myself from everybody because I don't want to come around feeling like I got an attitude or feeling like I'm just moody around certain shit. You don't want to be like that. And yeah, I feel like maybe you could talk and be like, man, look, I got this going on. So I don't, this is why I'm the way I am. But you don't know how people, you don't know how people going to react. And the same time you got something going on, maybe they got something going on. So I don't want to bring my problems on you and you got your own shit going on. And that's all I'm saying. And this part, this episode in particular is just about expressing myself and not only expressing myself, but trying to help other people that got other shit going on in their life where they need to hear somebody got something going on with them. And maybe they just need to hear it. Because, like I said, this ain't even easy for me to talk about, as you can tell. But it needs to be said because it's so much going on in the world today as far as mental health. And not just because of this, just now, this lockdown now. People been dealing with shit for years as far as trauma. Whether it's shit that's going on with family members in the past, somebody doing something, certain things going on. You never know, man. You never know what somebody going through and what they came from. So when you got a friend, you got a brother, you got a family member, cousin, aunt, uncle, etc. You got somebody that you love, and it just so happened that they feel like you feel like they got an issue going on, or you feel like you can't talk to them for some reason. Just realize that they might have something going on, and you just might need to back off for a little bit and let them reach out to you, and then maybe you'll understand. Or if you the person that got the issues going on and somebody is trying to reach out to you and they keep trying to reach out to you, maybe you need to just let them know that, look, I got something going on and it's something real. And if you ain't really, really trying to listen and really, really be here, then I need you to just back off for a minute. But if you really trying to be here and you really trying to listen, then I'll let you know. But if you're not, then I need you to back off for real. Because ain't nothing like expressing yourself to somebody or actually explaining certain thing that's going on with you, and they just turn around like they don't give a fuck, or they gonna go just tell somebody else about the shit. And then it's like, oh wow, it putting you in a deeper space where you don't want to be around nobody, or you don't want to talk to nobody, or it's putting you in a space where you're going in a deeper depression as far as your mental health. But I just wanted to dive into some of the mental issues that I see going on, or some of the stuff I have going on, or seeing certain things I feel like other people might have going on, and feeling like if you need to listen to this episode or if you need to reach out, because I ain't got the answers. I can tell you that now, but being somebody that goes through certain things as far as mental health or going through depression sometimes, or have certain things that's going on in my life where I have to take a step back and stay away from people, then this is the episode for you. And for the people that see certain people going through things, or you think somebody got depression going on, this is the episode for you too. So you understand people do have certain things going on, and they're not being funny. They're not being mean. You just got to give them a space or give them a chance to talk to you. But if you're going to listen, listen. Don't just throw it to the side. But thank you for tuning in. This was episode 23 of the Low Key Podcast Therapy Session.
But drunk words is sober thoughts. So I'm still speaking the truth. And what I'm still speaking is truth. This is your youngest son speaking to you, mommy.
Talk to me, mommy. I told y'all, I love that.